Hey tech fans, what's going on? So we all know Computex 2019 just ended, and just like AMD, NVIDIA had some announcements. Now you guys all know Quake 2. This is a game that pretty much everybody has played. Myself personally, I'm kind of a Quake tournament kind of guy, but hey, Quake 2 is also awesome. Now, this game was originally launched in 1997, but now NVIDIA has made it the world's first game that is fully path traced, which is a ray tracing technique that unifies all lighting effects such as shadows, reflections, refractions, and more into a single ray tracing algorithm. But I guess what's probably really cool is right now they're offering a free Quake 2 RTX download, and this includes the first three single player levels. Now, if you own the game, you can experience the whole game fully path traced. Now, the minimum specifications for this, however, are an RTX 2060 card. And on June 6, you can download it for both Windows and Linux. NVIDIA also announced that Wolfenstein Youngblood will include RTX, DirectX ray tracing, and NVIDIA adaptive shading. Now, for those people who want to get a free game, NVIDIA is also bundling Wolfenstein Youngblood with select RTX GPUs, the 2080 Ti, the 2080, the 2070, and the 2060. And they're also bundling it with select desktops and laptops. Now, according to the NVIDIA website, this sale is going from May 28th to August 6th, 2019, so get your game on. Another game announcement is Sword and Fairy 7 will be using ray tracing for reflections and shadows. They also revealed the first RTX trailer of the game. And you guys can see, this looks pretty cool, right? Other news from the NVIDIA front, G-Sync Ultimate gaming monitors will now have mini LED displays. First coming from Acer and Asus, now these monitors, they're going to run at 144Hz at 4K in full HDR10, and they're also going to have a 576 zone LED controllable backlight. Now this is 50% more from the previous, which was at 384, all on a single 27-inch screen. Now what this technology does is it shrinks the size of the lights that illuminate the display, enabling the integration of more LEDs per display. This gives the monitor greater control over the brightness and illumination of the picture, giving you deeper blacks, contrast ratios up to 1,000,000 to 1, better visuals, and lower click-to-action latency, and have even better color accuracy at a peak brightness of up to 1,000 nits. Asus just announced the BFGD, the Big Format Gaming Display, a 65-inch display running up to 4K at 120Hz with 1,000 nit peak brightness, G-Sync Ultimate HDR, DCI-3 color, and ultra-low latency. You know that thing's gonna cost a pretty penny. And if you're looking for something that's more of a curved monitor, Acer and Asus also announced 35-inch curved G-Sync Ultimate displays. First up is the Asus ROG Swift. This is the PG35VQ. It's a 35-inch monitor, has a resolution of 3440 by 1440, 21:9 aspect ratio, G-Sync Ultimate, 1000 nit HDR, an 1800R curve, and a refresh rate of a whopping, yes, up to 200Hz. Now, Acer is also going to release their Predator X35. Obviously, it's a Predator, and it's going to feature the same features as the Asus monitor. NVIDIA also announced 25 new laptops with NVIDIA features like NVIDIA Studio for gamers and creators. Lately, we've seen NVIDIA trying to get more and more monitors out there that are G-Sync compatible. And it seems like even though they've done a lot of extensive testing, out of 508 that they were available to test, 272 of those failed due to insufficient VRR, which is the variable refresh rate range. 2008 failed due to image quality or other issues, leaving only 28 G-Sync compatible monitors. NVIDIA also has these findings released on their website. We'll have a link down below if you guys want to check out more information. But it really does seem like NVIDIA is having some really strict guidelines to get your monitor approved for G-Sync compatible. And last but not least, before I bounce out of here, there have been three new G-Sync compatible displays. The Dell 5241-7HGF, the HP X25, and the LG 27GL850. This brings the total number of G-Sync compatible validated monitors to a whopping 28. Alright folks, so that wraps up today's video. Like usual, we'll have links down below to everything that we talked about today, so if you want to check out more information, make sure you see those links. And hey, if you like what you saw, you know what to do. Sub the channel, turn your notifications on, and that way we'll see you guys back on here for more videos. I'm Elric, we'll see you guys back here for more tech on Tech of Tomorrow.